spiritual disease, being homosexual is a spiritual disease. No. Kasi kung spiritual disease yan, sabuyan mo ng holy water lahat ng bakla, uusok yan.
Hi, I'm Gigi Esguerra. I'm a 21-year-old heterosexual trans woman.
I am Theo Catalo, and I am a gay man who expresses himself as a male.
Hello guys, I'm Yves. I'm currently the Director for External Affairs of Pantay. Pantay is the Philippine Anti-Discrimination Alliance of Youth Leaders.
Hi, I'm AJ Salazar. I'm 22 years old. I'm a transgender woman. I started my transition when I was 17 years old.
Hi, I'm Jenjen Dumawal. I'm a law student and I'm 24 years old.
SOGI is short for sexual orientation, gender identity / expression.
So each individual, they have their own SOGIs.
Yun yung magkasabi sa'yo kung lalaki ka, babae, bakla, tomboy, or asexual.
Sexual orientation is the way that we, in a word, love.
It refers to the person you're romantically or sexually attracted to.
For example, if I'm attracted to the opposite gender, then I am a heterosexual. If I'm attracted to the same gender, therefore I am a homosexual.
Gender identity is how we identify ourselves.
There's two concepts to this, which is being cis or cisgender or being trans or transgender. So for example, pinanganak kang lalaki and right now you identify yourself still bilang isang lalaki. Therefore, you are cisgender.
So for those that are born biological male, their gender identity can be female.
Now, therefore, you are transgender.
Expression is how we present ourselves.
If you're going to present yourself as a feminine persona or a masculine persona.
You can be a transgender woman, but your gender expression is not fully female.
The anti-discrimination bill and the SOGI bill has been in the Senate and the Congress for about 20 years already. And until now, it is still being apprehended by society.
Aside from these, some LGBTQIA+ members now prefer to be called Mix instead of Miss or Mister. These terms got some senators confused.
There is no particular way of dressing ng ibang letters. Eh. Tama? How does a queer dress up? Wala. So now, yun ang problema. How will now a third person, how do you expect that third person to be able to read your mind when you are now manifesting it, lining up somewhere? You say MRT, LRT, so...
I think that's a valid question na how do you approach an individual you're not sure of in terms of their SOGI, right? Pero sabi nga naman ni Susan Roses, huwag mahiyang magtanong.
If you're not sure to call someone sir, ma'am, edi ask first before assuming.
Because the more you ask, the more answers you will receive, the more educated you will become as a person.
I get that the point dun, yung point niya dun is like, how would he parang prevent on discriminating someone or disrespecting someone based on SOGI, huwag mo na lang pakialaman yung tao kung wala ka namang magandang sasabihin. Hindi mo naman kailangang i-call out na, ay, bakit ka nandyan? Dito ka, no.
When a person wants to be identified as someone else or as another kind of expression, another kind of gender, it's all about respect.
Ako ba tatawagin mong sir? Talaga ba? Cheka.
It's okay to not know things. To be faced with something you're not used to is an opportunity to learn, is an opportunity to educate yourself.
Do not let your prejudiced minds or your bigoted thoughts to get in the way of the rights of other people.
Ang dami ng studies, like well-documented studies, na it's not just male-female, not even biological sex, there's intersex, hermaphrodite, tapos even with gender identity.
I admit, it's gonna be a very big adjustment, not just for the community, but also, especially, most especially, for the heterosexual people.
What he said was so discriminatory, that we have to read minds in order to adjust to what the LGBTQ wants to happen. That's not what the LGBT wants to happen. What they just want is equal rights and respect.
The only way we're gonna do that is by being open to asking questions we never thought should be asked in the first place.
The term now is LGBTIQA.
Plus.
May plus pa? Okay, so... Ihingi sana ako ng definition ng IQA, pero kung may plus pa, bawal ang katapusan pala ito. So, why that 90 letters?
Why not just Homo sapiens?
Ah.
We're all
yes.
The same.
No. Yes, Mr. President.
Why do we have to segregate the gays from the lesbians?
Naiintindihan ko where they're coming from na
he thinks na labels will actually divide more of us.
Hindi naman sila iba, blah blah blah. Pero the metaphor analogy that they said is wrong, or that gender and sexuality is a lot more complex than that.
The reason for why there has to be an LGBTQIA community is because of years of maltreatment and discrimination are ways of us being treated differently.
Hindi niya kasi nagigets na yung LGBTQIA plus community seeks for that recognition in the society.
Ang daming tao na natatawa na we have so many labels like LGBTQIA plus.
There are a lot of gender identities in the spectrum of the LGBTQ.
Hindi na recognize ng tao na yung pagdagdag ng labels sa LGBTQ that's based on psychological studies.
It's not the term homo sapien, but rather addressing what the soji is of every single individual.
Senator Soto, as a person in power, should be educated enough to understand that homo sapiens is not part of those expressions.
We really cannot see any wisdom on crafting a law just for that purpose alone. Okay. Otherwise, pwede rin sana ako, eh, paano kung yung mga walang buhok, dapat eh, hindi ka discriminate, di ba? No, hindi gagawa din sana ng batas ng ganon. We cannot make laws, no? That is tailor-fit to a certain group lang. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, everybody will have their own laws.
Okay.
I think ang point doon is that ayaw niyang bigyan ng recognition or ng law to protect a certain group.
People have always been oppressed, and there's always been a minority. I mean, women weren't allowed to vote before. Black people weren't allowed their own liberties to walk the streets freely.
Meron din tayong laws for farmers, for nurses.
Actually, in social media, a lot of people are saying na if yung LGBT magkakaroon ng laws protecting them from discrimination and exclusion, paano yung mga pangit? Like, they get discriminated din naman.
That is a misconception.
Kaya nangihingi ang LGBTQIA plus community ng law na ganyan is because
may mga karapatan ang mga taong hindi LGBTQIA members na wala kami ngayon.
Like, for example, trans women are getting killed just because they're trans women. May napatay na ba because they're ugly? Charot.
These are laws that were not meant give special treatment to LGBTQIA members.
The SOGI Equality Bill, it's not just for a certain group. It's actually for everyone in society.
Even if you're a straight man, even if you're a straight woman, bakla ka man or tomboy ka man, if you are discriminated based on how you identify, then dandun yung sanction. Hindi ko pinapasok sa bar kasi babae ka. That's soji-based discrimination.
Their comment on having special laws for certain sectors, it's not a violation of the Constitution.
A lot of people are misconstruing or misinterpreting the law that once this law has been passed, basta transgender ka, lahat ng trabaho makukuha mo. This is not true. For that job that you are trying to offer, syempre ang importante pa rin ay yung qualifications mo as a person. But as a trans individual, if you are applying for the job and you are truly qualified for it, pero hindi ka niya tinanggap dahil LGBTQIA member ka, that's the problem there.
It's the transformation of us being a more accommodating society to everyone.
And they're not just special rights, they're equal rights. So.
With your respect, I love them because God loves us all as sinners. All of us are sinners. Pero hindi sa aking analysis, kung yan eh, spiritual decision eh. God created mankind in His own image. In the image of God, He created them, male and female, He created them. To create another gender and multiplicity of dangers, this is a direct rebellion to God.
I think what's funny about that video is when Brother Eddie was saying to create genders, and then he actually does a Freudian slip and says to create a multiplicity of dangers.
To create another gender and multiplicity of dangers.
Sabi niya dangers. Sure ako, nadulas lang siya, pero grabe, if you think about it, yun yung nilalabanan niya eh. Ayaw niyang maging labas pa sa babae at lalaki.
This is a touchy subject because, of course, the Philippines is a religious country. I came from a religious family.
I came from a Catholic school ever since I was in elementary.
We're a predominantly Catholic country, pero not all Filipinos are Catholic, so you should never use the Bible para i-argue na hindi ipasa yung soji bill.
There's what we call the principle of separation of church and state.
Yung mga lawmakers na always nagsasite ng Bible or yung Adam and Eve argument, not Adam and Steve. Oh my God.
Every person has a right to their civil and secular rights. And this includes equality. Secular rights, civil rights are for all. It should not be based on religion.
Spiritual disease? Being a homosexual is a spiritual disease? No. Kasi kung spiritual disease yan, sabuyan mo ng holy water lahat ng bakla, uusok yan. WHO already said that it is not a mental disorder or mental disease.
I mean, you see people of the clergy, nuns, priests, they voice out na, no, you're not wrong for being gay, you're not wrong for being transgendered. It's okay. Kasi tanggap ka ng Diyos for it.
If Jesus lived right now amongst us, I would see Jesus rallying for the Sochi Equality Bill because Jesus has always been there to support those who are constantly marginalized by society.
Even in the Senate hearing, sasabihin nila na may respeto lang sila sa community, may rami sila mga kaibigan, katrabaho na bakla or tomboy. But, lagi silang may but, lagi silang may pero. So gets, naka-cancel yung love or acceptance or respect nila with the person.
However, this bill does not state that they will disallow you from believing in what you believe in.
He can say what he wanna say.
Okay lang naman if you have your own thoughts on these things, if you have your own belief system.
So if you believe that we LGBTQIA members are not your equals, okay, it's fine. Just don't shove it down our throats that we are not your equals.
We're not all Catholics. Hindi lahat ng tao may paniniwala. So why base it on that?
We must not mix as much as possible religious beliefs in the legislations and the laws that are presented in society today. We have to give a concession that there are some vague provisions in the Soji Equality Bill.
That's why I get na some people are not fully supporting it.
And of course, Senator Riza Ontiveros is open to amending those and fixing those.
What the community wants is just safety.
Hindi naman kayo pinipigilang sabihin yung mga paniniwala nyo. Okay lang na sabihin mo sa akin masusunog yung kaluluwa ko sa impyerno. Tanggap ko na yun. Pero mo sabihin sa akin, hindi ko pwedeng makamit ang pwede mong makamit. Porket ba ding ako?
It's not special treatment. We should just try to understand and educate ourselves and inform ourselves in order to have a peaceful manifestation of what we really want, and that is acceptance and equality.